force between parallel current carrying conductors. Force between parallel current carrying conductors. Now this is the conductor. Now this is the conductor. This is the conductor. Here this is also conductor. Now this is called AB conductor. This is called, what to say, CD conductor. Through the AB conductor, what is the current? I1. Through the CD conductor, what is the current? I2. What is the separation between these two? That is, R is the separation between these two. Now, here, at a distance of R. Now, due to the current carrying conductor AB, due to AB, magnetic field induction at a distance of R. At a distance of R is given by, right? Now consider only this conductor. What is the name of the conductor? AB. What is the current passing through this one? I1. Therefore, around this one, there is a magnetic field. At a distance of R, here what is the magnetic field? The magnetic field B, due to the AB is equals to mu naught by, what to say, that is 2pi into I1 by R. Due to this current carrying conductor, at a distance of R, what is the magnetic field? Magnetic field BAB. Due to the current carrying conductor I1, at a distance of R, what is the magnetic field induction? The magnetic field induction B, that is magnetic field induction B of AB is equals to mu naught by 4 pi I1 into R divided by R. Now, this is called first equation. Now, this CD conductor is in the magnetic field of BAB. Now let us consider, now CD conductor is now in a magnetic field B of AB. Now let us consider, here there is a magnetic field. In that magnetic field, this is the conductor. Just now I told you, current carrying conductor is placed in the magnetic field. No doubt it will experience a force. Now, due to this one, there is a magnetic field. In that magnetic field, there is a CD conductor. Due to this one, there is a magnetic field. In that magnetic field, there is a conductor. That conductor will experience a force. Or otherwise, due to the CD conductor, There is a magnetic field. In that magnetic field, AB is the conductor. Then it will experience a force. Right? AB is the conductor. Around the AB conductor, there is a magnetic field. In that magnetic field, CD is the current carrying conductor. Now, the CD is the current carrying conductor is placed in the magnetic field produced by the AB, that is represented by B of AB, then CD will experience a force. What is the force? F is equals to force on CD. What is the formula? I L B sin theta. Now force on CD is equals to what is I? What is the current? I2 is the current. That is I2 is the current. What is the length of the conductor? L. What is the magnetic field? B of AB. B of AB. Here theta. Theta is equals to what to say? 90 degrees. Therefore force on CD is equals to I2 into L. B of AB is equals to what to say? Mu naught by 2 pi into I1, that is by R. Therefore this may be written as force is CD is equals to mu naught by 2 pi, right? That is I1 I2 into L by R. This may be generally written as F is equals to mu naught by 2 pi into I1 I2 by R into L. Therefore that is force per unit length. Force per unit length mu naught by 2 pi into I1 into I2 by R. Therefore here the currents are in the same direction, there is attractive force. The currents are in opposite direction, there is a repulsive force. That force per unit length is equals to mu naught by 2 pi I1 I2 by R. Now by using this definition, by using this formula, Ampere is defined. Ampere is defined. Ampere is defined. What is the ampere? Now here, what is ampere? I1 is equals to 1, I2 is equals to 1, R is equals to 1. Therefore F by L is equals to mu naught by 2 pi into I1 is equals to 1, I2 is equals to 1 by what to say? R is equals to 1. Therefore F by L is equals to mu naught by 2 pi into, that equals to 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7 by 2 pi. Therefore pi pi gets cancelled, 2 1 ja 2. Therefore F by L is equals to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 newton per meter. Now the force between the two current carrying parallel conductors can be defined. Force per unit length is equals to mu naught by 2 pi into I1 I2 by R. Now from this formula only we can define the current unit ampere, right? Now here the two conductors are separated by unit distance. The two parallel conductors are separated by unit distance. Whenever they are traveling, whenever through which the unit current is passing, there are two parallel conductors. What is amount of current? Unit current is passing. What is the amount of current? Unit current is passing. What is the distance between them? Unit distance. In such a case, if the force existed per unit length, if the force existed per unit length is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 newton per meter, then the current is said to be 1 ampere, right? The two parallel conductors are separated by unit distance, through which unit currents are separated, through which unit current is passed, then the force per unit length is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 newton per meter, then the current is said to be 1 ampere. The two parallel conductors which are separated by unit distance, through which unit currents are passed, if the force per unit length is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 newton per meter,